Hello, hello. Welcome. The number you were trying to reach has been disconnected. That's what Cameron, our director of contemporary music, used to do. He would reply back to the text message and put it in the little caps and say, "We're sorry, the number you're trying to reach has been disconnected. Error code, whatever. But good try. I know you haven't disconnected your phone, so answer your phone." But he lives about 5 houses down here, so all I had to do is go out into the driveway. "No, you're there. Answer your phone."
So now, where is the best place to put it?
I'm going to turn the lights off.
Huh? Where's the best place to put it?
I think about really number 10 is a sweet spot, but I told too many people before you got here.
Okay.
So there's 2 events going on in Naples almost simultaneously. One's at 4 and one's at 7. So there's a lot of us down there, down there. Which is fine. Yeah. But it was just, sorry, I make a good door, don't I? Okay.
Good afternoon. You all got quiet before my mic was on, and it scared me. Sorry. Well, good afternoon. Welcome here to New Hope Presbyterian Church. I just cannot thank you all enough for coming. I know there's a lot going on, and it's a beautiful day here in Southwest Florida, so thank you for spending an hour of it with us here at New Hope. My name's Ben Ball. I'm the director of traditional music and the organist here, where I get to play this beautiful instrument every Sunday, and I'm still checking my pulse every now and then to make sure that that's actually true and not just a dream. But today, you're not here to hear me, because I'm delighted to welcome Mr. Jason Payne from just outside of Atlanta as our guest organist for the formal dedication of this new instrument. The instrument was installed in October of this past year, and I'm still looking forward to many, many years of exciting worship services and concerts led by its many tonal capabilities. At this moment, I would ask that you would silence any of your digital devices. I don't think it would be very practical that Mr. Payne would want to play a spontaneous duet for organ and cell phone, but you never know. And if you would look in your program, there's two notes. The opening hymn, we will stand to sing that. It is printed on the back of your program. And there's a little prescription for how we're going to sing it by verse. It's up in the top left. Now, if you're a lady and sing on the men's verse or vice versa, we're not going to have the ushers remove you. But it just mixes it up a little bit and keeps us all from singing all six verses. And the second thing is, following the benediction that Pastor Eddie will bring to us at the end, you're asked to, instead of like in a worship service where everybody takes out as fast as they can, you're asked to be seated again and hear the last piece. Now, those of you familiar with that particular work will know you don't want to leave before it's over. It's an exciting piece, and I can't wait for you to hear it here. And I really want to impress this upon you, that installing an organ of this magnitude is something that is very, very special in the life of a church and community. And you think, it's an organ. Well, yes, it's an organ, but it is a very grand instrument with lots of capabilities to praise our sovereign Lord. And with that, would you join me in prayer? Heavenly Father, we just give you praise that in your grace and your love, that you allow us to praise you, that you have given us voices to praise you, that you have given us musical abilities to praise you, that you have given us instruments with which to praise you, and that you have given us the ability to see, to hear, and to appreciate the beauty of your creation. Because music is but one part of the way that we praise your holy name. We acknowledge that all creation, all the beauty around us comes from you, and therefore we must care for it and return it all back to you. More than any humble offerings that we can give, we know that you want our obedience and the sacrifice of our hearts, and for us to be humble and repentant before you and to walk with you in the glorious light of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And we pray that as we formally dedicate this instrument to your service and glory today, that it would never just be a source of pride or mere entertainment, but that it would be used to play worshipfully and reverently before you, to your glory in both worship and concert. May it never be a statement of ourselves or how we personally think music should be played, but may it be played with joy and enthusiasm for your glory, and also with sensitivity and tact, with an attitude of worship and reverence, and with the proper sense of our privilege in bringing our praise before you. And Lord, today we lift up Jason and thank you for his skill and sensitivity in playing this recital this afternoon. And finally, Lord, we just ask that you would bless us in our worship of you. Use us, Lord, and help us in the work we do to tell others of the greatness of your name, to make your message known, to bring you glory and honor in the expansion of your kingdom. And we pray all these things in the strong name of our Lord and Savior Jesus. Amen. Would you please join me in welcoming Jason Payne?
Thank you.
seated. A reading from Psalm 150. Praise ye the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary, praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts, praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet, praise him with the psaltery and the harp. Praise him with the timbrel and dance, praise him with stringed instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high-sounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Okay, trying to calm my nerves here a little bit. Welcome, thank you all for coming. The weather is lovely out, and I certainly appreciate it. I know everyone at New Hope appreciates everyone being here as we dedicate this fabulous instrument to God's glory. This afternoon, we're going to hear hymns that we all know and hopefully love. You'll hear different takes on them, maybe a little different from what you normally expect to hear. And the hymns that we will be listening to are hymns that have power written throughout them. You just heard one very powerful hymn, obviously. But we'll hear a lot of promises of God that assures us as we go through the journey of life. So today's program of power and promise are ones that hopefully will remind you of God's love and can speak to your heart in a special way. The next piece we're going to hear, When Morning Gilds the Skies, everyone thinks of hearing it on a Sunday morning, but I'm going to play it in the afternoon. But if you listen closely, you will hear the sun rise, and then eventually it will kind of smack you in the face. But the hymn is beautiful. It speaks of praising Jesus Christ. There is a special promise in the words of that hymn. It's found in the second verse. Does sadness fill my mind? Everyone goes through difficulty, I'm sure, through life. But the verse says, does sadness fill my mind? A solace here I find. May Jesus Christ be praised. Or fades my earthly bliss? My comfort still is this. May Jesus Christ be praised. And hopefully that promise that in the hymn, When Morning Gilds the Skies, is one that will speak to your heart this afternoon.
Thank you.
So I come from Atlanta, Georgia, and I'm married, and I have four children. So this weekend, I'm on vacation. My wife is not so appreciative of that, but no, we have four kids, and they're all a blessing from God, and I'm grateful. As every parent knows, you go through a process of putting the kids to bed at night. You know, sometimes it takes 5 minutes. Usually it's about 20. But as we go through that process, the very last thing I always make sure I tell my kids is Jesus loves you. It's the very last thing I want them to remember as they go to sleep. The renowned theologian Karl Barth was once asked if he could summarize his whole life's work in theology into one sentence. Barth said something like this. He said, yes, I can. In the words of a song I learned at my mother's knee. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. And I think that's about right, sums it up. The arrangement you're going to hear of Jesus Loves Me here in a moment, it's got a very whimsical theme at the beginning you'll hear, and it sounds like, you know, kids are jumping along and having a good time, very kind of a whimsical theme. The piece will progress, and then it'll build into a very bold and glorious restatement of Christ's truth that Jesus does love you. He loves everyone. He loves the whole world. So that promise that we have is the world, should be the world, hopefully, to everybody. But Jesus loves me. Did you hear the kids jumping around? The next two pieces we're going to hear are written by Keith and Kristen Getty. They're becoming extremely popular modern hymn writers, if you will. Many of the hymns that we sing are, you know, some are written hundreds of years ago and have become, you know, standards of our faith. But the Gettys have become in demand in many churches throughout the country and worldwide, for that matter. I'm sure you've heard of the piece "In Christ Alone," probably the most prominent piece, I would assume. "Speak, O Lord," "Power of the Cross." There's several that they've written, and I decided to write a couple arrangements on some of the Getty pieces. We'll hear "In Christ Alone." Of course, that speaks of the birth, the death, and of course, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And then the second piece immediately after that I will play is "Speak, O Lord." "Speak, O Lord," maybe it's a little less well known, but Keith Getty explained why he wrote it this way. He said, "One of Christianity's distinctives is that we worship a God who has spoken, who is not silent. From God the Father, speaking the world into creation, to speaking through his living word in Christ, to speaking by his Spirit through the written word. This hymn prepares people to humbly listen as they are taught and respond to the huge consequence Jesus Christ has on their lives." So we'll hear "In Christ Alone," and then immediately after that, "Speak, O Lord." There is a hymn entitled Nearer, Still Nearer, and I couldn't tell you the last time I've ever sung it in a church, unfortunately, but it is a beautiful, beautiful hymn with some amazing text. It may or may not be in your hymnal. Feel free to grab one and look in the reference. It was written by an American Methodist hymn writer, Layla Morris, many years ago. It's a very powerful hymn, and it reminds us that Jesus is with us no matter what. And it assures us of our eternal home that Christ is preparing for us. The words to this hymn, or at least out of a couple of the verses I selected, are in the program. I would encourage you to meditate on those words as you hear me play this arrangement of Nearer, Still Nearer. The last verse that speaks of the eternal home that we will have in heaven is just glorious. It speaks of the glory that we will see one day. So meditate on the words Nearer, Still Nearer as I play this arrangement. As Christians, we know that without Christ, we cannot do anything. But with him, we can do everything. Our need for Christ is expressed so well in the hymn, "I Need Thee Every Hour." And the text states, "I need thee every hour, most gracious Lord. No tender voice like thine can peace afford. I need thee, oh, I need thee, every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior, I come to thee." So I hope this hymn, "I Need Thee Every Hour," will minister to your heart as well as we listen. One of the joys of being a musician is getting to play your instrument and risking the pages being blown off of the music rack. A lot of musicians are going to iPads and digital devices, and I just couldn't quite pull the trigger for that, even though I do have one, and I try it every once in a while. We have one final piece here before the ending of the program here in a moment. A Mighty Fortress Is Our God. I think this sums up the power and the promise, both, that we have through Christ. How Jesus Christ is our bulwark, never failing. I think it was last year was the 500th anniversary of Luther nailing his theses to the door in Wittenberg. And I wrote this arrangement coincidentally at the same time. I didn't even know when I wrote it that it was the 500th anniversary, but hey, why not? So we'll listen now as we hear A Mighty Fortress Is Our God, and I will pray that the pages stay on the music rack.
Ben asked me, I'm the pastor of the church, one of the pastors, if I would come up and have a dedication. I noticed he didn't put me in the program. But we want to dedicate this for the glory of God. And what that means is that this instrument, taken from the raw materials of God's good creation, has been put together, designed, ordained to enhance the reputation not of Ben, not of Jason, you're pretty good, not of New Hope Church, but to the glory of God. And I pray that that will be the case. And secondly, to dedicate something to the glory of God means to enjoy it, to be filled with the pleasure of God and to thrill. And I just thought, man, as he was playing that, what delight in the gift of Jason and the gift of this organ, but in the gift of the greatness and the majesty and the beauty of our God. And before I have a prayer of dedication, I also want to say a word. I want, Ben didn't ask me, but I'm going to dedicate this organ, not only to the glory of God, but I want to dedicate it to the pioneers of this church. This facility is in many ways a gift from many of the pioneers of this church, most of which are no longer here and of which will not fully enjoy it. And so the reason I dedicated to them is because they have built this facility and they have been mainly responsible for this gift of this organ, I believe, for the glory of God, because many of them will not be around and are not around anymore, and that many of God's people throughout this area will enjoy it and be drawn to the beauty and the glory and the majesty of God. Amen? Oh God, we would just give you thanks for this gift of this man. Thank you, oh God, for the gift of Ben and for the marvelous gifts and talents that you have given to them. We're so thankful, oh God, for those who have had a vision to bring glory to you through the instrument of this organ, who have given so generously, not only of this instrument, but given for this whole campus, and that we might be just a little light in this area as we seek to gather every Sunday to worship you, to make your name great, to esteem your glory, to know that because you so love the likes of us in Jesus Christ, that we might be people who sing and who dance and enjoy the very best gifts of your creation and of the bounty and surplus of your gospel. And so we dedicate it for your glory and for your enjoyment, and we do so in the strong name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and we continue to do so as we stand together to praise you, our great God. All right, hit it, Jason. love and the grace and the glory of God fill our hearts and minds now and forevermore. And all God's people said, amen. Thank you.
That's all, folks.